Dear students, starting with the next lesson, lesson number 3 of the unit number 2, accessing methods and attributes. In this lesson, you will learn how we can call the instance methods, how we can call the static methods, how we can call the functional methods, what functional method is, how we can access the public attributes of a class. So starting with the first topic, calling methods. Generally, I have already discussed about the class. A class consists of generally attributes and methods. So in this example, if you will see, we are calling motor underscore on method of the class LCL underscore vehicle. So an object reference to the class go underscore vehicle uses the data statements. The syntax to call the methods motor underscore on consists of the reference variable. The syntax to call the method motor underscore on consists of the reference variable followed by the object component selector and then followed by the method name. The name of the method must be followed by the open and close parenthesis with a space in between. So if you want to call the method of a particular class, firstly, we need to create the reference variable, and reference variable we generally create with the help of data statement, data, then reference variable name, then type refer to class name. Then we can call the particular method with the help of reference variable, then object component selector, and then method name, and then braces. And there must be some space between the braces. So by this way, you can call the method. You can also call the instance method. Suppose if you want to call the method of a class, then we can use the statement call method, then reference variable, then component selector operator, and then method name. And then you can also use this, the interface parameter like exporting, importing, changing, receiving, and exception parameter that you can specify in the method call. A shortest syntax is also supported here. That means you no need to be use this call method. This is an optional part. You can use directly the reference variable, then component selector operator, then method name, and then interfaces. This is an example how we can call this instance method. This is a data and this is a reference variable go underscore vehicle, which is a reference variable of the local class vehicle. Now you are calling this get underscore type with the help of this reference variable, then component selector operator, and then method name, and then braces. There must be some space between these braces. So we are using here the space between the operating and left braces. And there is space between the right parenthesis and these parameters. So by this way, you can call the instance method. Now come to the next one, how we can call the static methods. The same thing that I have already discussed about this one, how we can call static method. Generally, the component operator change from single minus and greater than sign to equal sign and then greater than sign. But in case of static method, we can not use the reference variable. We generally use the class name. So the syntax is call method, then class name, then component access operator, then method name, and then interfaces, importing, exporting, changing, receiving, and exceptions. And there is shorter syntax is also available. There is no need to use this call method here. So just directly use the class name, then component access operator, and then method name, and then interfaces. This is an example how we are calling the get underscore n underscore vehicle static method. This is our class name, local class vehicle, then component access operator, and then method name, and then passing the parameters. Now come to the next topic, functional methods. Generally, the functional methods are defined as a method that have exactly the one returning parameter. They can only have the importing parameters and exceptions. So functional methods are different from the instance method, static methods, as well as the normal methods. It has a special characteristics. The functional methods are the method that have exactly one returning parameter, and they can only have the importing parameter and exceptions. A functional method we can call explicitly assignment of the receiving parameter. The functional method can call implicitly within the various expressions such as move, case, loop statement. That means when we are using this move, case and loop statement, then we can call the functional methods. We can also call this functional method when we are using the logical expression if, while, check, wait, until and so on. We can also use or call functional methods when we are using the arithmetic and bit expression. So by this way you can call the functional methods. Now come to the next topic. This is a functional method example. You can see in this example the call of the functional method is shown supplying all the necessary parameters. The second example shows the call of the functional static method in short form. So you can see we have a class. This is class name and their definition. This is method. This is normal method, functional method, get underscore average underscore fuel. And these are have a characteristic that is only importing parameters. So this is importing IV underscore distance, type is S underscore distance. Here S underscore distance, S underscore capacity and S underscore consum that are ABAP dictionary types, user defined types. So we have returning parameter here. Now you can see this is our main method where we are declaring the reference variable of the class local vehicle. This is go underscore vehicle 1 type referred to class name, then go underscore vehicle 2 type referred to local vehicle, and then we are calling this functional method in the expression. This is generally an expression we are in which we are evaluating something. So this is go underscore vehicle 1, then component access operator, then functional method name, and then passing the parameters and then adding the values of this distance into this one and fuel level into this one. So by this way you can call the functional methods. The second example is showing how we can call the functional static methods. You can see again with the help of this class name and then member component access operator, member access operator, and then functional method name. Come to the next topic, accessing public attributes. As I already discussed, when we are declaring the attributes in a public section, that can be accessible directly to the class as well as outside of the class. The static attributes are accessed only using the class name, but the public attributes we can access directly with the help of reference variables. So you can see, suppose in this class local vehicle, we are declaring the some attributes mv underscore make, mv underscore model, and the type is string and read only. And this is our static attribute class data, gv underscore underscore vehicle, type I and read only. Now you can see how we can access these attributes by creating the reference variable. So in this case we are creating the reference variable go underscore vehicle type referred to class name, and then making the object, create object go underscore vehicle, and then go underscore vehicle mv underscore make. And the static attributes we can access with the help of class name. So class name is LC underscore vehicle, and then component access operator, and then static attribute which we have defined using the class data statement. So these are only accessible if the attributes are public. Directly you cannot access if you have put in these attributes in private section. With the help of method you can access, but if you have declared into the public section, then you can directly access the attributes. So this was all about the lesson number 3 of the unit number 2.